Hi students, welcome to Srinivas physics classes. Till now if you not subscribe my channel, subscribe, share and comment. Today I am going to start the fourth chapter, that is moving charges and magnetism. In this chapter we are going to discuss about the moving charges and its effects. And the relation between the electricity and magnetism, how electricity produces the magnetism, okay, that all things we are going to discuss. The relation between the electricity and magnetism also we are going to discuss. Okay, now let us see some basic properties of magnet. I am going to explain this, you learn in the lower class only. Then the properties are, the first one is attractive property. That is, attractive property means the magnet can attract the small pieces like iron, cobalt, nickel. And next one is the directive property. What is directive property? It means if you suspend the magnet from rigid support, then it can shows the geographical north and south. That means based on this concept, they made the compass. That means the in the compass there is a small magnetic needle will be there, and that is pivoted over a pin, and that will act as a compass and it will shows the geographical north and south directions. And the next property is the induction property. That means one magnet can, if it is in contact with the iron, then that iron also converted into magnet, it can also have the attracting power, and that is the magnetic property is induced in the another magnetic substance, that is called as induction property. And the next one is, one more property, every magnet has the two poles, one is the north and the south, and like poles are repel with each other, unlike poles are attract with each other. That means north north and repel with each other, south south repel with each other, but north south are attract with each other. Now let us see next property, that is the magnetic poles always exist in pairs. That means isolated poles does not exist. That means if here there is a magnet, it has the two poles, one is north and south. And if we cut this magnet into several pieces, then each piece has two poles, north and south. That means if we cut it here, then one end will act as north and other end will act as a south. That means we cannot produce the isolated poles, okay. And this is the, these are the basic properties of magnet. Let us see next some definitions, basic definitions that are useful to understand this chapter. That is, what is magnetic pole? What is magnetic pole? Most of the, you see this diagram, whenever this magnet is dip in the iron dust, the most of the iron dust is attracted and attached at the end of the magnet, okay, at the both ends of the magnet, the more iron dust is attached. That means most of the attractive power of the magnet concentrated at the two points that are at the edge of the, at the end of magnet, okay, on both ends attractive power is more, that both ends are called as poles. There are two poles are there, okay. Most of the attractive power of the magnet concentrated two points in the magnet, the two points are called as magnetic poles, and these are located at the ends of the magnet. Look at here, the north pole is located at this point and the south pole is located at this point. That means at the two points the most of the attractive power will be there. And the next one is, let us see pole strength. What is the pole strength? The ability, this here we are telling the two poles, every magnet has the two poles and that poles have the attracting power. The ability of a pole to attract or repel another pole is called as the pole strength. The ability of a pole to attract or repel another pole is called as pole strength. For example, this is the north pole, and if we bring any other magnet north pole near to it, then it can repels like that. The every pole has the attracting or repulsing ability. The ability of a pole to attract or the repel another pole is called as pole strength. And pole strength is a physical quantity, its SI unit is ampere meter. And the next one is, what is magnetic length? The magnetic length is the shortest distance between the two poles of magnet. Okay, look at here. This is the north pole, this point, small circle, and this is the south pole, this is a small circle. And now the distance between the shortest distance between the north and south poles is called as magnetic length. Okay, the geometrical, that means the poles does not exist, the poles does not present exactly at the end, they are little bit inside the magnet, okay, not at the end. That means the magnetic length is this one, but the geometrical length of the magnet is this one. Look at here in the diagram, in the geometrical length. Geometrical length means we will measure from the ends. The geometrical length is more than the magnetic length. Magnetic length is the distance between the two poles only. But the geometrical length of the magnet is the length of the magnet. Length of the magnet we can measure from the ends of the magnet, right? And now geometrical length is more than the magnetic length. And magnetic length is less than the geometrical length. Okay. And magnetic length is the shortest distance between the two poles of magnet is called as magnetic length. And the magnetic length is denoted with the U2L. Why we denote with the 2L? Generally, the magnetic length measured from center. Look at here. This is a point. From here, this is the center. And from left side, we are taking the length L. And the right side also, we will take the length as L. From the center, the north pole distance is L and the south pole distance is L. Then the total distance, what you will get, this is the center point. From center, south pole distance L. From the center, north pole distance L. At that moment, the magnetic length is the distance between the two poles, that will become 2L. The magnetic length is denoted with the 2L. And magnetic length is a vector and its direction is, its direction is from south to north. Look at here the next point. That is the, you see here the, magnetic length direction. The direction of the, magnetic length is from south to north. And let us see. Next, magnetic length is a vector, its direction is from south to north. And what is the relation between the magnetic length and geometrical length? What is magnetic length? Magnetic length is the shortest distance between the two poles of magnet. Look at here. The magnetic length is the shortest distance between the two poles of magnet, but the geometrical length is this one. Okay, magnetic length is equal to, we will get as 0.833 into geometrical length. For example, geometrical length of the magnet is 1 centimeter. Then what about the magnetic length? That is 0.833 centimeters. Okay. Magnetic length is equal to 0.833 into 1 centimeter. That means magnetic length is 0.833 centimeters. Okay. And let us go for the next. That is one more definition. What is magnetic moment? The magnetic moment is the product of pole strength and magnetic length. Okay. The pole strength is small m and magnetic length is 2L. The product between these two is called as magnetic moment. It is denoted with the capital M and its SI unit, the pole strength unit is ampere meter, length unit is meter, ampere meter into meter, we will get as ampere meter square. And the next, magnetic moment is also a vector, its direction is from south to north. Look at here, this is the south and this is the north. The magnetic moment direction is from south to north. Look at here, south to north. Okay. And next, what is magnetic field? This magnet effect will exist up to certain region. That region is called as magnetic field. Now let us see the magnetic field strength. Okay, we can measure by using a physical quantity, that is B. Okay, now next definition is magnetic induction or magnetic flux density or magnetic field strength, simply magnetic field. It will give the strength of the magnetic field, strength of the magnetic field around the magnet. Its effect is exist up to certain region. Okay, now the magnetic induction or the magnetic flux density, the strength of the magnetic field can be measured by using a physical quantity that is called as magnetic induction or the magnetic flux density or magnetic field strength or the magnetic field. There are various names are there, and this is the this can measure the strength of the magnetic field. That means it for example, if we place some substance or some object near the magnet, then how much force is acting on that, whether large force or small force. Okay, how much force is acting, that can be measured by using magnetic induction. Force experienced by unit north pole kept at a point in the magnetic field is called as magnetic induction. Look at here, the formula for the magnetic induction is F by M. Here you take the F as M as 1 unit. If you take the M as 1 unit, then we will get the B is equal to F. That means force on unit north pole is equal to magnetic induction. Magnetic induction is equal to force, but at what condition? If you take the unit north pole, at that moment the magnetic induction is equal to force. The SI unit of the magnetic induction is force by pole strength, Newton per coulomb or Tesla. Okay, and now other unit is gas. The relation between the Tesla and gas is 1 Tesla is equal to 10 power 4 gas. This is important physical quantity. Strength of the magnetic field can be measured by using this physical quantity, that is magnetic induction. Let us see, magnetic induction is a vector. Its direction is away from the north pole and towards south pole. The magnetic induction direction is away from the north pole. This is the north pole. If you want the magnetic induction at here, that will be away from the north pole, and magnetic induction is towards south pole. Magnetic induction is similar to the electric field. You know electric field formula, force by charge. Similarly here, magnetic field formula, force by pole strength. Instead of charge, here pole strength will come. And here electric field, already we know that it is radially away from positive charge and towards negative charge, but the magnetic induction is away from north pole and towards south pole. Now, Oersted experiment. What is Oersted experiment? When a magnetic compass placed near a current carrying conductor, then compass needle deflects. Look at here, this is a current carrying, look at this diagram. This is a current carrying wire. Below this, we are placing a compass needle. This compass needle is deflected when we place near the current carrying conductor. Okay, and here in the two situations, right, look at here, when the current goes right side, the deflection will be right, and anti-clockwise, like this it will be there. And now when the current direction is reversed, then the deflection also reversed. That means when we place a magnet compass near the current carrying wire, then the magnetic needle is deflecting, compass needle is deflected. That means generally when a magnetic needle will be deflect, if we place the magnetic needle in the magnetic field. For example, external magnet you will bring nearer to the compass needle, at that moment the compass needle will be deflect. That means compass needle generally deflect in the external magnetic field. But here the compass needle is deflecting near the current carrying wire. That means near the current carrying wire also magnetic field produces. That is the conclusion. The conclusion is that around current carrying wire also magnetic field produces. That already you know, electromagnet can be made by using this concept. Whenever a current carrying wire is wound over a iron nail, then that iron nail can attract the magnets, attract the small pieces of iron like that. That means this will act as a magnet. And now the direction, we know that around the current carrying wire magnetic field will be produces. Then the direction of the magnetic field is given by right hand thumb rule. That is, according to right hand thumb rule, what we have to do, we have to hold the current carrying wire in our right hand. Okay, in our right hand, current, look at here this diagram, and the current carrying wire is held in right hand in such a way that this thumb shows the direction of the current upward, and then curled fingers, this rotated fingers, and then that fingers indicates the direction of magnetic field. This vice versa also, vice versa means if you reverse this, here what thumb shows the current, curled fingers shows the field. If curled finger shows the current, then thumb shows the field. It will be reverse also. Okay. And this is about right hand thumb rule. Thank you for watching my lectures. Next lecture I will continue on whiteboard, okay, marker, by using marker pen. Thank you.